Today we're talking about just the idea of a Congress, an entity with the efficiency of a Hummer limo that has a leaky gas tank. Now, each party controls one part of Congress that should really push this system into gear, if that gear is reverse. I'm not sure if you've heard, but in a spectacular race, no Steve King, not that race, I'm talking the midterms, the Democrats won the House and Republicans gained more seats in the Senate. Everyone thought they had won and that the other party had lost because of this. So that's good. The problem is that in all of the coverage of the midterms, one thing I have not heard is what the House and the Senate actually do. I feel like a guy who just won The Apprentice. Yes, I won! Now we get to work for Donald Trump! What's my job? Maybe I should have read the fine print, because in one of the funniest Trump quotes I've read about this show, he says it's a little bit too much to ask someone to be the president of an $800 million building when they haven't had that kind of experience. Yeah, just because someone's good at winning a reality TV show, if they don't have any experience, they're not qualified to be president of a building. So back to the midterms, because Democrats have the House, which means that
They get control of some very important committees in the House. The Oversight Committee, for example, the Judiciary Committee. What this means is they have oversight over the Cabinet, over the White House, over the President's business dealings. They will be able to subpoena documents. They will be able to subpoena even the President's tax returns.
Oh man, I smell some fun Supreme Court episodes coming down the pipe. Democrats have already released a list of proposed investigations, so long it would make Agatha Christie tell them to calm down a little bit. This investigative ability is no way special to the House, as I'm sure you've heard of some Senate investigations too. But much like the ability to block bills, it's just significant that the Democrats now have the ability to do it. Speaking of, Democrats can now block bills, which sounds like a great victory for them until you realize how painfully little passed last year. It's insane. They passed 97 laws, which places them around here with regard to productivity. And that's with one party control. Now, you might have heard last week Paul Ryan say,
"You take a look at the bills we passed out of the House, about 1,000 bills. It's been one of the most productive sessions of Congress in a generation."
So one of us is lying, and in an argument between Speaker of the House Paul Ryan and YouTuber Steven, who's celebrating his 294th subscriber, well, I think I know which side has a little more prestige. The problem with his message is that the House did pass a ton of bills. Those bills just didn't pass in the Senate, so they went nowhere. It would be like me bragging about how I just got a one-on-one interview with President Donald Trump, because I sent him an email requesting it. Because bills have to go through the House and the Senate to pass, we should see the numbers dip significantly lower in the coming year. Although it will be a ton of fun to watch because we finally get to see Republicans go full radical. Remember how they blinked on Obamacare repeal? Well, now they have the House that's going to be their friend at the bar who holds them back, so they can act fully crazy without actually getting into a fight. Hold me back! Hold me back! So now, let's talk about the actual differences between the Senate and the House. First, let's talk about the lower house, or the House of Representatives, which, to reiterate,
the Democrats have won control of the House.
The first House responsibility is to, and this should really annoy Republicans, originate all revenue bills. Now some of you might be thinking, oh goody, giving liberals control of our checkbooks. What could go wrong there? The responsibility is specified in Article 1, Section 7 of the Constitution, in case any of you have enough initiative and doubt to check for yourself. Basically, if you want to raise the revenue, it's coming from the House to the Senate for either approval or notes for the writing of the next draft. The other specific House responsibility is to initiate the articles of impeachment, which can't imagine why that would be a useful piece of information to know about in the coming year. This portion, specified in Article 1, Section 2 of the Constitution, says that the House of Representatives has the sole power of impeachment, which requires approval from the Judiciary Committee and a simple majority, 51% in the House.
History unfolding in the nation's capital today as a somber House of Representatives voted for only the second time in American history to impeach a president of the United States.
Now remember, the House can't just say, "Hey Donald, you're fired." This only starts the process that ends with the House of Representatives making their case to the Senate. And I think we all know how that would go right now. Which brings us to the higher house, also known as the Senate.
The Republicans have retained control of the Senate.
Now, what makes the Senate special is, first, its ability to approve all major presidential appointments. Now, if you're a liberal, this should be, what's the opposite of music to your ears? This should be polka to your ears. Supreme Court justices, attorneys general, these jobs definitely fall into the category of major presidential appointments. Already, winning the House feels kind of like the Christmas where your grandmother gave your brother an Xbox and you a calculator. Be grateful for what you got now. But wait, there's more. The Senate gets control of approving and writing the treaties the US enters. That might not sound like much considering Trump pulls out of treaties like they're porn stars, but it will give the Senate considerable control in drafting trade deals with China and the rest of the world. There was a worry that a Democratic Senate could derail the new NAFTA agreement, but that's not going to be a problem anymore. Oh yeah, and one more pretty important role of the Senate.
It was up to the House to decide whether there was grounds to impeach the president, and then it is up to the Senate to conduct the trial and act as essentially the jury.
The said William Jefferson Clinton be and he hereby is acquitted of the charges in the said articles.
It's literally a yay or nay vote amongst the senators, and if two-thirds agree, then you're out of there. Don't worry though, Trumpeters, the only thing you can get two-thirds of senators to agree on is a pay raise for senators. So there you go. Democrats get to write the bills relating to revenue and then have them be judged by the Senate and start the impeachment process. And Republicans get to approve all major political appointments, treaties, and oversee the president's impeachment trial. More importantly, Democrats finally get a seat at the table. Sure, they have Senate supervision and a sippy cup, but now we'll hear their policy suggestions outside of every award show except the Country Music Awards. And hey, if worse comes to worse, Nancy Pelosi, or at least I'm assuming she's going to be Speaker of the House, will be third in line for the presidency. So, Democrats, you might want to ease off on insulting the president about his cheeseburger-based diet. Might I introduce you to the KFC Double Down? Anyways, that's what the different congressional responsibilities are. I think I'm falling on Team Republicans to who won this one, but until next time, thank you and that's all I have to say about that. Hello YouTube, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to support independent, nonpartisan comedy news, remember to subscribe by clicking on this floating logo to the right of my head. Or do it the old-fashioned way by clicking the subscribe button below. Click that bell so that freedom will continue to ring, and remember to give me a thumbs up if you like what you saw. Lastly, as always, thank you for watching.